Hello everyone, welcome to Phil's Art. I thought I would do a portrait drawing of this lady today. This lady is Virginia Woolf. She was an English writer considered to be one of the most important authors of the 20th century. She was born in 1882 and she died in 1941. I've done this drawing using a propelling pencil, this one here. It's a 2B lead. The paper I've used here is Strathmore pastel paper, and the colour is velvet grey. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use two colours using Carbethello pastel pencils. I'll put the link and the name of the materials that I am using in this. There's the first one. It's a red colour, and the second will be a white. I have done one before, I believe, some time ago. The technique I am going to be using is called Chiaretto Osoro. I think that's how you pronounce it. Chiaretto Osoro. It's an Italian word and it means dark and light. And that's the word, that's the technique I'm going to use. Rembrandt used this technique an awful lot. The light shone from one direction. As you can see with this drawing, the light would be shining there and the shadow would be there. And so that's the technique that I'm going to use. Chiaro Osoro. Sorry for the pronunciation. Anyway, let's get started. As I say, the links will be down below and I'll remove that and we'll start the drawing. Thank you. got to be careful with the white that you don't sort of overdo it. I think that's about it. Okay, so that's the finished portrait of Virginia Woolf. I think I'm reasonably accurate. She'd got a very prominent nose here, and that's the hard part in getting it right. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed that. Just before I do go, I've done this here so you can see that, and there you can see the dark values, the reflected light, the half tones, and the highlight. There aren't particularly very many highlights on this particular drawing, photograph that I've taken it from, but you can see those are the dark shadows here. The reflected light is here, dark shadow again there, and there. There's a little bit of reflected light there, and then there's the highlights, and then there's the half tones, which is there, which is the paper. You let the paper do the half tones, if you like. Anyway, I hope that's been useful to you. Don't forget to subscribe, and please put the like button, and see you again, and keep safe and keep painting and drawing. Okay, see you again. Cheers, Phil.